Hey, welcome back. Glad you guys could join me again. This following video is going to be something I put together to give you guys an example of how those that are in control of this system has been playing with our minds and how they do it. Okay, the following will be showing you how they subliminally put things on your in your spirit and on your mind, how they brainwash you and desensitize you. Okay, we're going to take a look at this sitcom that was out in 2010 called Frankie and Grace, Grace and Frankie. It's about two women that were married to two men. They was friends, were so-called friends, and both of their husbands were business partners. Okay, they ended up becoming homosexual lovers and they ended up divorcing their wives, and this is the lives of the wives, stories being told through the wives. Okay, we're going to take a look at that and how they use a heavy symbolism in this sitcom and how they use entertainment, comedies, thrillers, all kind of stuff that they use to indoctrinate you with this type of stuff. Okay, and a lot of people don't know what they're looking at, then they're wondering why certain things is going on with them in their household and stuff after they've watched, spent all this time watching these sitcoms. Okay, let's take a look at it. See how it goes
with the opening credits and opening scenes. You pretty much see how this sitcom is going to turn out.
No.
Pay close attention to this next scene that's coming up.
Think of your happy place.
I can't. This is it. And it's going to fall through the earth at any moment.
Out of state happy place.
Okay.
Yeah.
Check this out.
Good.
This book that he has is the book that they are reading to your children in the school system.
Do we need to get a restraining order?
No. No, I didn't even think that you... I did call, but you didn't answer. It's probably because you saw me calling.
What are you doing here?
I brought you a gay penguin book.
What?
It's for the kids. You said that they were having trouble understanding, and I thought that this might help explain how...
How two penguins could have a secret homosexual affair for 20 years?
No. You said that they were having
trouble... Watch how they slide this next scene in. They're also trying to slide in the seed of pedophilia.
No, we're going to write that book. This is a more generalized gay penguin information.
Thank you.
This is it.
You're welcome. What's going on over there?
We're taking Maddie off the pacifier, so we planted them, and now lollipops will grow.
Oh, I don't think you understand how gardening...
Did you catch that?
I don't think you understand how children work.
Planting a pedophilia seed.
How does it in your bike have a seat on it?
Oh, I traded it for the gay penguin book. Are the kids home?
Coyote, I do not think that's a good idea.
Right. No, I was just wondering if one of them had a bike seat that I could borrow, but...
Okay, let me see what I can do. Can you just stay out of trouble for 5 minutes?
This next scene is them laughing at you. Because they say that is over your head.
Oh, it's amazing. It's so cool.
What? Now this scene right here, showing you a couple of pictures, they're going to show you this stuff. This is the Kabbalah Tree of Life. Okay, they're going to flash it. Pay attention to the wallpaper when you see this next scene. Okay, this is the ancient flower of life. This is the Masonic symbols that they use to perform witchcraft and rituals. Okay, this is what they're putting in front of you through the entertainment and comedy in a funny form, where you're watching this stuff and you're receiving this stuff subliminally, and you don't know what you're looking at unless you are familiar with how the occult works and do research and find out what's really going on. Now this is the flower, ancient flower of life, and the Kabbalah combined. This is what they're going to show you in this wallpaper in this next upcoming scene. This is how they indoctrinate you through these movies and sitcoms. Pay close attention to the wallpaper. She's pointing to it, drawing your attention to it.
About a year ago.
And also desensitize you to this gay movement, homosexual movement.
Get out of this house.
Why don't I go?
No. I've never really liked this
if
house.
If you don't know what you're looking at, it's just all in your face.
I have a question. When people ask me why we got that house with
and they put it on you,
I tell them what you told me.
Subliminally, you think you're looking at them in
a
comedy, but
we could only afford
the main things that they are putting on you is
that's
in the background. You gotta always pay attention to the background.
Yeah.
Now this scene right here,
I'm over there with Judy and Peter.
They're making fun of the church.
Excuse me, if you're going in the kitchen, could you get me 2 whiskey sours, 1 for each hand?
Basically letting you know that they control the church.
The first thing I thought of was you, because I knew you'd come. I'm over there with Judy and Peter.
Padre, excuse me, if you're going in the kitchen, could you get me 2 whiskey sours?
Letting you know that they are in complete control of what's going on.
When Larry died, the first thing I thought of was you, because I knew you'd come.
Now this scene right here,
I just want to know where I come.
They're going to flip the script on you, because we know who the Jews are,
the
fake Jews, Ashkenazi.
Like, can't you understand that?
No.
Listen to what the brother says.
Black Ashkenazi Jew living in San Diego, understand about that?
Exactly.
I just want to know where I come from. San Diego, the Bergstands. I want to sit across the table from someone who looks like me. Can't you understand that?
No. What would an adopted black Ashkenazi
Jew? We know who the real Jews are.
San Diego, understand about that?
Exactly.
Okay. If you notice, who was sitting across the table from him was a black guy. Okay. This is an Ashkenazi Jew right here. These are the Khazar and Ashkenazi Jews that are spoken of in the Book of Revelations 2:9 and Revelations 3:9. This is who Jesus ousted out as being the synagogue of Satan and the seed of Satan, which got him hung on a tree.